than inside China on a daily basis, which I think is a pretty critical shift in this situation.
In the United States, there are now more than 300 cases in almost half the states and at least 15 deaths, with the latest death being reported tonight out of Florida. There are still not enough coronavirus tests to meet the national demand, adding to the fear that the real extent of the outbreak may not be fully understood in the United States. The Trump administration has been taking a lot of heat for how it has responded to the spread of the virus. There have been concerns about the president's messaging when he has spoken in public today. The president visited the Centers for Disease Control in Atlanta after he signed an $8.3 billion emergency funding bill that had just passed Congress. His comments today seem to imply that there was no shortage of test kits.
Anybody right now and yesterday, anybody that needs a test gets a test. They're there. They have the test. The tests are beautiful. Anybody that needs a test gets a test. But anybody that needs a test can have a test. They're all set. They have them out there. But as of right now and yesterday, anybody that needs a test, that's the important thing.
But less than an hour after that, Vice President Pence, who is leading the White House Coronavirus Task Force, held his own briefing and acknowledged that the government was still working on making its test kits available to everyone.
Two of America's leading commercial laboratories have announced that tests will be available by Monday of this week. With the announcement of these major commercial labs, we trust in a matter of weeks, the coronavirus tests will be broadly available to the public and available to any American that is symptomatic and has a concern about the possibility of having contracted the coronavirus.
During Trump's visit to the CDC, he also spoke about the Grand Princess cruise ship being held off the coast of San Francisco with more than 3,500 people currently on board. Coronavirus tests were delivered to the ship by helicopter. This afternoon, Vice President Pence announced that 21 people, 19 crew members and 2 passengers, have tested positive for the virus. Testing came about after a man who was on a previous voyage tested positive and died from coronavirus. Today, Trump said he didn't want the administration to take people off the cruise ship because it would double the number of those with coronavirus in the states.
I would rather, because I like the numbers being where they are, I don't need to have the numbers double because of one ship. That wasn't our fault.
The president then went on to praise his administration's efforts.
I think we're doing a really good job in this country of keeping it down. We've really been very vigilant, and we've done a tremendous job of keeping it down. I like this stuff. I really get it. People are surprised that I understand it. Every one of these doctors said, how do you know so much about this? Maybe I have a natural ability. Maybe I should have done that instead of running for president.
And so the coronavirus continues to take its toll on the financial markets with another sell-off today, even amid reports that the economy added more than 270,000 jobs last month. Meanwhile, city officials in Austin, Texas, have now canceled the South by Southwest Festival, which was set to start a week from today. As all this unfolds, President Trump has just announced another major personnel shift at the White House. Is Captain Mark Meadows, North Carolina Republican House member, leader of the Freedom Caucus, and a tireless Trump advocate.